More than 200 species of salamanders have been banned from entering the U.S.
Some are brightly colored and secrete irritating substances.
The government is worried that foreign salamanders could infect American salamanders with a devastating disease.
You think of salamanders and you think like, oh, okay, salamanders, what's the point of saving them? But, you know, they're a huge part of the ecosystem. I'm Brian Resnick. I'm a science reporter at Vox.
We don't think of salamanders as an iconic American animal, but they are.
I spoke to Matt Gray, a professor of wildlife ecology at the University of Tennessee, and he was telling me that if you take all the bears, the raccoons, the birds in the Great Smoky Mountains, and you put them on a scale, so you put all the animals on the scale, and then you put on the other side of the scale all the salamanders in the forest, the salamanders outweigh everything else.
About 50% of all salamander species in the world come from North America. So what's going wrong? Well, there's this fungus.
Bat trachochytrium salamandrivorans. Okay, I have no idea how to pronounce it.
There's this fungus called beesal, which is believed to have originated in Asia. It spreads in water and erodes a salamander's skin, which they use for breathing and excreting toxins. For many species of salamanders, when they get this fungus, they die. So how could a fungus like beesal travel all the way across the world to the U.S.? Well, Asian salamanders are colorful, so they're imported for pet shops and zoos. They have developed an immunity to beesal, but they're still able to carry it to regions like the U.S. where salamanders have no immunity and are the most vulnerable. A few years ago, biologists in the Netherlands discovered the fungus in a prevalent species of fire salamander there.
Their populations got reduced by 90% or more than 90%.
The fungus is also related to the ones that have been killing frogs around the world. So understandably, scientists are doing everything they can to stop it from coming to the U.S. The sheer density and diversity of salamanders make them a vital link in forest food chains. They're a source of food for mammals like raccoons and foxes, for birds, for fish and reptiles as well.
They eat everything that's smaller than them, so they eat tons of insects, tons of little bugs.
And here's something to think about. Salamanders help prevent carbon from entering the atmosphere.
So when leaves fall to the ground in a forest, there's all these little insects, worms, or larvae that eat the fallen leaves. And in doing so, they kind of shred them up and release some CO2 back into the atmosphere.
Salamanders prey on these bugs, and in doing so, they help keep carbon locked in leaves.
It's like there are so many salamanders, it's hard to imagine what ecosystems look like without them.